In the previous video, we prepared a C3D motion capture file to be used in Face Robot and applied it to the animation controls on our zombie. In this video, we'll finish animating our zombie's face by keying the eye blinks as well as the controls around the eyes and lips, most of which are already animated by mocap or lip sync animation. By adding keys on top of the existing animation, we can alter it as we like to add more expression to our zombie's performance. We'll first use a pose-to-pose animation technique to block out these main poses that represent our zombie looking around, uncertain and anxious. Animating in pose-to-pose is a great way to focus on your character's key performance poses. For doing this, we'll use a stepped interpolation, which makes the animation snap from one pose to the next, removing any transition in between. In the animation preferences, you can set the interpolation type to stepped, also called constant, so that it's automatically used for the F-curves that are created when you set keys. To start off, we'll animate the movement of the LookAt control, which determines the direction in which the eyes are pointing. Unlike most of the other controls, this control doesn't have any animation on it yet, so we can key its translation directly. First, click the T button on the Transform panel, or press the V key to activate the Translate tool. Then set an anchor key with the current values on the first frame by clicking the Key Selected button on the Act panel. You can also set a key by clicking the standard Softimage key icon or pressing the K key. Now go to frame 13, move the control to our zombie's right to make his eyes dart nervously in that direction, and set a key. Then go to frame 85, move the control to make him look anxiously to his left, and set another key. Continue moving the control to make him look forward, up, forward again, and to his left, setting keys at each pose. Finally, go to frame 300 before the lip sync starts, move the control so that he's looking at the camera, and set a key. Now you need to edit the F-curves to refine the eye movement, so press the 0 key to open the animation editor. We want his eyes to dart from one pose to the next, but also hold his stare at each pose. An eye dart can take as little as 1 to 2 frames, but our zombie is a little slower than most living humans, so we'll use 3 to 4 frames for him. Go to the first frame where you want to add an anchor key and choose Keys Insert Key at Current Time to set keys for both F-curves at the same time. Go to frame 78 to set another anchor key on both F-curves. This time, simply middle-click the Keys menu to repeat the last command. Continue adding anchor keys to create plateaus for each of the main poses. When you're done, choose Edit Select All Keys or press Ctrl+A and click the Linear Interpolation button. This interpolation type makes the eyes dart between poses at a constant speed. Next, we'll animate our zombie's lower lip controls to support his nervous eye movements. These controls are currently driven by mocap retargeting operators and are also driven by the speech action clip for the lip sync over these frames, which we'll look at later. We'll mute the audio for the lip sync for now. We'll start by setting keys on top of the retargeting operators as offsets to the mocap animation. Activate the Translate tool and set an anchor key with the current values for the controls at the beginning of the timeline and at frame 13, where our zombie is looking to his right. Go to frame 24, move the lower lip up to close the mouth, and set a key. Then go to frame 85, where he's looking to his left, move each of the lower lip controls so that you get a lip-biting expression, and set a key for each one. Continue moving the lower lip controls for each of the main poses to create different expressions, setting keys for each one. Click the arrow buttons here to move from keyframe to check what each pose looks like. Then select all the curves and all the keys on the curves and click the spline interpolation button to create smooth transitions between each key. You can reinforce the expressions of each pose by keying any of the other controls, but for the purpose of this tutorial, we'll move on. With the blocking done for the main poses, change the interpolation preference from constant to spline so that subsequent keys will use a smooth interpolation. No facial animation would be complete without eyes that blink, so we'll do that now. In the previous video, we set the weight of the mocap animation on the eyelid controls to 0 so that the mocap animation wouldn't affect them. With mocap data, the eyes don't always blink when you want them to for your character's performance, so you can use the blink tool to create customized eye blinks. This tool makes it easy to key blinks for all 4 eyelids at a time, at the desired frames. You can choose from 4 blink types, including the nervous one, which we'll use for our jittery zombie. Each blink type has F-curves that define its animation style, for both the upper and lower eyelids. For the nervous blink type, you can see how the upper eyelid starts closing a bit faster, and the lower eyelid reopens more abruptly than for the standard blink. You can key the right and left eyelids separately, or key both at the same time. You can also control the timing of the blinks, whether the right and left eyelids are synchronized or offset. Since our zombie has some muscle control issues, we'll offset the right eye blink a bit from the left. You could exaggerate the blink offset by using a wider range of frames for the random offset values, but we'll stick with the default values. Now that you've set up the eye blink properties, you're ready to key them. Although you blink regularly to alleviate eye dryness, a blink also corresponds to a change in thought process or to a mood or emotional state, such as the anxiety and fear our zombie is currently experiencing. You also tend to blink when you turn your head and change the direction of your gaze. Armed with this information, let's go to a frame just before our zombie glances to his right and click the key blink button. Then go to frame 39 and click this button again. Click the Edit Curves in Animation Editor button and adjust the resulting F-curves for any or all of the 4 eyelid controls. You may have noticed that when you edit a curve, a faint black line remains visible. This is called a buffer curve and is a snapshot of the curve's original shape before you changed it. You can click the Swap Buffer button to revert to this buffer curve, which is a quick way to undo any changes you just made. You may also want to use the Animation Editor to delete a blink, since it's actually composed of several keys. Make sure to select all the key points for that blink and then press the Delete key. Before we continue adding blinks, we'll edit the curve on the Nervous Blink tab as we just did in the Animation Editor, so that all subsequent blinks will feature this change. If you've already worked out on which frames you want the blinks to be, you can click the Key Multiple Frames button and enter all the frame numbers here. Click OK, and Face Robot sets the blink keys on all these frames in one shot. When you blink, the orbicularis oculi muscle that surrounds your eye contracts in order to close your eyelids. Reproducing this movement will help the animation look more organic and believable, even if he is a zombie. Face Robot uses the orbital controls around each eye to mimic this movement. We'll also animate the eyebrow controls so that they move at the same time as the orbitals. Like most of the other controls, the eyebrow controls and lower orbitals are driven by the mocap retargeting operators, but the upper orbital controls aren't. This is because the mocap markers used for the C3D file we applied in the previous video didn't map to the upper orbital controls. However, we can set keys on all these controls at the same time, regardless of their animation state. Activate the Translate tool and set anchor keys in this neutral pose for all the controls at the beginning of the timeline, just before our zombie blinks, and just after he blinks. The muscle contraction is slightly offset from the main eyelid motion, So move the upper controls down to compress the muscles about a frame after the eyelid closes, and set a key. Then move the lower orbital controls up at this frame, and set a key. You can now see how he contracts his muscles a bit when he blinks his eyes. Repeat this pattern of keys for each set of eye blinks. To make this go faster, you can copy and paste each set of keys for each control, and then adjust the keys as you like later. Another way to make the blinking more believable is by animating how the pupils move down as the eyelids close, and then up again as the eyelids reopen. This gives the impression that the eyelids are actually pushing on the cornea, which adds an organic feel to the overall blinking motion. Using the keys we just set on the orbital controls as a reference, go to a keyed frame where the eyelids are starting to close and set a key for the current values of the LookAt controls position. Then go to the keyed frame where the eyelids are reopened and set another key using the current values. Now go to the keyed frame where the eyelids are closed, move the control down a bit, and set a key. You can continue keying the control's movement in this way for each set of eye blinks. We're going to add one more realistic detail to the eyes animation, and that is to make our zombie shift his focus a bit when he's staring. This is because our eyes constantly make small, step-like shifts, even when they're focused on something. Set the anchor keys for the position of the LookAt control at the beginning and end of the stare. Then go to a frame between these two, move the control a bit in the opposite direction, and set a key. Copy that key's value and paste it a few frames later to hold that eye shift for just a bit. Continue doing this type of movement for the areas of animation where he's staring. There's one more thing to adjust, and that is the lip's keyframed animation in relation to its lip sync animation. As we saw earlier, the lip, tongue, and jaw controls are driven by the speech action clip in the zombie's animation mixer over these frames. We also set keys on top of the retargeting operators for the lower lip controls. Normally, action clips override keyframes that are set on the same parameters over the same frames, but you can blend their animation. To do this, choose Mix Animation Mixer Properties in the Zombies Mixer and select the Mix Current Animation option. The lip controls are now also affected by the keyframes. You can set and key the mix weight value to blend in the keyframes as you like. At a value of 1, the keyframe animation is blended evenly with the action clip animation, since the clip's weight is also at a value of 1. But we'll reduce the weight of the keyframes since we don't want them to have too much influence over the lip sync animation. If you wanted to change the weight of the lip sync animation, you could set and key the action clip's weight value. However, we want to keep the weight value at 1 because the lips need to move correctly to form the words. The facial animation is now complete enough for this tutorial, but you can continue tweaking it as you like. In the next video, we'll bake all the animation that we've created in this and previous videos into F-curves so that the animation can be exported.
Please, sir, may I have some more brains?